Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over part 8 of our VBA series, and we're going to cover some string functions because oftentimes a string is brought into Visual Basic for Applications and it needs to be torn apart to drill down to a specific piece that is needed within your code. So today, we would like to cover several different string functions, including the left function, the right function, and the mid function. So to start this process, I'm going to go up to View, Macros, Record Macro, and I'm going to type in parse strings and say OK. And then I'm going to go back to Macros and say Stop Recording. And I'm going to hit Macros one more time and look for my parse strings macro and hit Edit. The reason I did this is because I want this macro to be created in a module so that I can call it at any time from Excel and not have to create a button or an event like we've been doing in the past. So what do I want to do here first? I would like to introduce you to the left function. What the left function does is it takes a string that already exists and it pulls out the leftmost characters of a string. So let's look at that. I'm going to Alt-Tab back to Excel and let's just take what's in cell A1 right here. So I'm going to Alt-Tab back to VBA and declare a variable. I'm going to say dim str left as string. And then I'm going to set str left equal to range A1. Don't forget the double quotes and the parentheses. And then I'm going to set str left equal to, and this is where I will use the left function, left parenthesis, str left, which is basically what I had in cell A1, comma, and at this point, let's just say 10 and close my parentheses. So I'm going to set a breakpoint here and I'm going to run my code and I'm going to track it in the immediates window. So let me Alt-Tab back to Excel, go to Macros, and run this macro. And now I've entered break mode. So if I go down here and I type question mark, I want to know what my str left variable is going to be. I did not hit enter yet because I haven't executed this line of code. I'm just stuck on this line of code. So if I hit function F8, you can see that the yellow highlight moves to the next line. But right now, what is my str left? I'm going to hit enter, and you can see that it's the entire path that I have written in there. But now if I execute the next line of code, which is where my left function has actually been introduced, where I'm taking the 10 leftmost characters of my string, and I hit function F8, if I come down here after str left and type enter, you can see that I've gotten the first 10 characters of this entire line. But look at the end of this. Do you see how this is a space right here? Sometimes we don't want to have a trailing space at the end or at the beginning. So I'm going to hit F8 one more time, and then I'm going to use a function here called trim for my left function right here. So I'm going to Alt-Tab back to Excel, go back to my macros, and run this macro again. Now I'm in break mode. So if I hit F8 and I go back here to str left, I can see that right now it's my entire file path. If I hit F8 again and go after str left and hit enter, you can see that my variable does not have a space at the end because I use the trim function up there. But if you look here at the one I previously had, you will see there is a space at the end. So this one right here actually only has 9 characters if you count them. And this one down here includes the space and it has 10 characters. So sometimes it's necessary to use the trim function to get rid of any spaces that are at the end. So I'm going to hit F8 again to finish running my code. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to get notifications of our new weekly Excel tips. Just as I have the left function, I also have a function called right. So I'm going to declare another variable here, strwrite as string. And this time, I'm just going to copy my left variables. And down here, I'm going to change them to strwrite. I'm just going to copy and paste. And I'm going to put the word right here instead of the word left. And I'm going to change my variable in here. So this time you can probably guess I'm going to take the rightmost 10 characters of this string. So if I Alt-Tab back to Excel and I run my macro and I just step through it using F8, I'm going to delete everything that I have down here for str left and I'm going to put str right. So what is my value right now? It is my entire path because all I did was set that variable equal to what was in cell A1. But if I hit F8 again, and I go down here after strwrite and I hit enter, you will see that I picked the 10 most characters, which happen to be my file name because my file name has 6 characters plus the period plus XLS. So that equals 10. So I can take 10 characters from the left, 10 characters from the right. I'm going to hit F8 to exit this. There is a third function I would like to introduce, and I'm going to hit enter here and say dim str mid as string. And the mid function is rather interesting. I'm going to highlight my str right here, and I'm going to hit enter a few times and just copy and paste my code. So I want to set my str mid to whatever I have in cell A1, but in this case, I want to use the mid function. And I'm still keeping the trim here because spaces can become rather problematic sometimes when working with a string. So I like to just trim up most of my string functions. So I'm going to use mid and replace the variable here. Now the mid function takes three arguments. If I hit the left parenthesis right here, you will see, first of all, what is the string I am searching? And I'm searching whatever I have in A1, which I set to str mid. And now I have this start as long, which means long means a number. So where do I want to start reading off my string? If I look down here at my entire path, let's say I would like to start reading my string at the second slash right here. This is over 17 characters. So I'm going to start it at the 17th character, and I'm going to go for 10 characters, and I'm going to close my parentheses and hit enter. So now I'm just going to set my breakpoint here, go back to Excel and run my macro. And down here, my code broke on str mid, so I'm going to hit F8. And down here, I'm going to do *str mid. And you will see, again, it's my entire path. But as soon as I hit F8 and I execute the mid function and go after my variable, you will see that I have now taken the first 10 characters that are after the second slash right here, which is exactly what I wanted to do. So we have the left function, the right function, and the mid function. I'm going to hit F8 to finish running my code. So in review today, we covered a few string functions. The first one we went over was the left function and the right function and the mid function. We also went over the trim function, which takes off any leading or ending spaces in a substring. Next week, we're going to go over how to dynamically find your place in a string based on other string functions. So hopefully you learned something new today, and look forward to seeing you again next time.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions, and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.